So you want to be a nurse. Well, being a nurse isn't about throwing on some scrubs and a fancy stethoscope. There's a lot more involved. So let's talk about it.
I'm a nurse. That's what I be. Ain't no one else like me. I'm a nurse.
Hi, welcome back to my channel. I am Nurse Master Charlie, and today we're going to be talking about how to become a nurse. On this channel, we talk about nursing, education, health, and music. So if you want to know more about health, nursing, education, and music, please subscribe as I'm going to be putting more videos about nursing, health, education, and music. Now, if you're in high school, make sure you want to have those good grades and kind of focus on the sciences if you can. Really focus on the chemistry, the anatomy, if they have that in there. Also, academies. Some high schools are doing like a health academy, or they have like a CNA course, so kind of focus on those. If you can take those classes, you can learn a little bit of a hands-on. And volunteer if you can. If they have little health fairs you could volunteer for. And it's never too early to start learning. Now, if you're not in high school and you want to follow your dream about being a nurse, well, go for it. But when you're changing careers, you have to worry about, if you're an adult, for example, and you have children, you have to worry about childcare. Have to worry about finances, life in general, about working, because sometimes we already have other jobs, we have obligations and responsibilities. So we have to keep that in mind also. So whether you're right out of high school, changing careers as an adult, or you're just in college and you just finally decided to become a nurse, make sure in those prerequisite courses, the anatomy, the chemistry, the math, the physiology, that you really focus on those grades. Grades are going to be of key importance when you apply to nursing school. If you can volunteer for health fairs or anything health related, that's going to give you a lot more exposure into what you're getting yourself technically into. Consider taking a CNA course. This is going to give you hands-on experience. You're also going to learn how to deal with patients, deal with other team members. It's going to get your foot in the door and provide some good contacts also for the future, like for references. And while you're thinking about colleges or nursing schools, make sure that you're choosing an accredited nursing school, because you want to make sure that your units or your coursework is transferable, just in case in the future you want to go on to, if you're going from an ADN or an ASN program, which is an associate degree, to a bachelor's degree program, to a master's degree program, or to a PhD or a DNP program, which is a doctorally trained nurse. So speaking of the different types of nurses, or the different type of degree type of nurses, there's associate degree type nurses, there's bachelor's degree type nurses, then there is eventually the master's degree type nurses and the doctoral trained nurses. So choose which one you want to go to, because people out of high school can go right into a four-year college and focus on a bachelor degree. A lot of times they can also go into an associate degree program. If you're changing careers, you're probably going to go into like a junior college and take the prerequisites there. So chances are they're going to be an associate degree program, but you can also transfer to a bachelor degree program. Once you're done with all the prereqs, you have to now apply to nursing school. So some schools make you take an entrance exam, something called like a TEAS test. That's in my area. They will require a letter of recommendations. This is where the contacts from either your job as a CNA or something in healthcare, or if you're not in healthcare, a letter of recommendation from an employer, a coworker, something to kind of build you up, to sell you, to help get you into the program. Some schools will do an interview process. You may have to sit down and talk to one person, two people, or maybe a panel. They're gonna question you about maybe why you wanna be a nurse. So grab some family members, a friend, have them start drilling you with questions about why you wanna be a nurse, why you chose that school, whatever. And then you have to wait for the answer, whether they're gonna accept you into the nursing program or that school. But don't be discouraged. If you get a no is not permanent. People have applied in my area, I hear from the students that I work with, one time, two times, three times, and then they finally got in. So do not ever give up.
Do not ever give up.
All right, so you've been accepted to nursing school. Now what? Now you want to start preparing your life. Start organizing your time, your family, your kids, your job, if you're going to work. Sometimes a lot of schools will try to discourage you about working just because of the amount of demand that the program is going to put on you. Be on time for your classes, for your clinicals, and go prepared. Go with your books, with your notebooks, with your pens and your pencils. When you go to clinical, make sure that you take a stethoscope, maybe take a pen light. Always want to be prepared in case they need you to look at somebody's pupils, for example, but always be prepared. Forming study groups, some people do really well in groups, some people don't, but sometimes forming a study group can help you learn things that maybe you're having difficulty with learning, or when they're talking about assessments, maybe you can grab somebody to practice on, because you can ask a family member, which is great. However, the family member may not be able to tell you whether you're doing something wrong or right. So if you grab a schoolmate or somebody in the program with you, if you're doing an assessment wrong, they can say, well, don't do that part there, do this instead. Always go with a positive attitude, whether you're going to class or to clinicals. Because you don't want to be a Debbie Downer. You want to make sure that you're going with a positive attitude, that you're going there to learn. All right, while you're in clinicals, whether you're in a hospital, whatever medical setting you're in, if you see something or hear something and you don't know quite what it was or what it is, when you get home, research it, look it up, because there's a good chance you're gonna come across that again, but this time you're gonna actually know what they're talking about or what you're actually seeing. If they ask for a volunteer to do something, jump in and do it. You may be a little scared, go with your instructor or the nurse that you're with that day that you're following. That way, when it happens again, you have a little bit more experience doing it. You won't be so afraid. Also, while you're in nursing school, you want to make sure that you want to go above and beyond. Not just in nursing school, but in life in general. But you want to go above and beyond because you are a walking resume. You are showing your fellow colleagues, your nursing students, your instructors. You're also showing the nurses that are on the floors that you're working with or whatever clinical setting you're in. You're showing maybe their managers, whoever is always, somebody's always watching. And so you want to make sure that you're doing your best, looking your best. That way you become a walking resume when the time comes for you to apply for a job. And also patients are going to be noticing you're a student, but they may see you have a little bit more confidence because you're jumping in and doing stuff also. Maybe join organizations such as the Student Nurses Association, because that's part about being a professional nurse is getting involved with things to be a part of change if it needs to happen. All right, so you're all done with nursing school. You've taken your nursing finals and you've graduated across the stage. You've heard all that graduation music. What's next? Next is the NCLEX. The NCLEX is a test that all nurses have to take to basically deem you worthy to take care of patients. Now, once you've taken that test and you pass, you get a little license that gives you the legal part to say you can take care of patients. If somebody doesn't pass, it's not the end of the world. A lot of nurses will fail this test, maybe on the first try or the second try. It doesn't make you any less of a nurse once you hit the floor. So be prepared when you're gonna take this exam. Make sure you take a study course, go with a study group. Prepare for this, it's a big test. So you wanna prepare for this, not just over a day or two. Take maybe a week or two on a daily basis. I went to a course review where it was doing it. It was 5 days a week for about, I think it was a week or two. But anyways, take that test, pass it, and it's just less stress. And once you're done, now you can really focus on being a nurse. And the ultimate thing is to take care of patients and hopefully save lives. While you're in nursing school, make sure that you treat patients as if they were your mother or your father. That way, if you keep that mindset, when you're actually graduated and taking care of patients, you will be the best nurse that you could possibly be.
I'm a nurse, that's what I be. Ain't no one else like me. I'm a nurse, I got skills and training. I can do anything. I'm a nurse, that's what I be. Ain't no one else like me. I'm a nurse, I got skills and training. I can do anything.
You like that? That's my song titled, I'm a Nurse. It is on the NURISNG's Greatest Hits album. My album's been out for a little while, but that song is there's actually an animated video here on YouTube. That song is a part of my album, which is actually out on Spotify, iTunes, Apple Music, all the music platforms. It's been out for a little while, but like I said, it is a song to inspire people about being a nurse and tells people a little bit about what nurses do. Nursing students really like it. Nurses kind of like it. Anyways, check it out. I'll put a link in the card here or in the description below. Anyways, I'm a Nurse, the name of the song. All right, so those are my thoughts on how to become a nurse. The road to become a nurse, it's not an easy road. There was a lot of studying involved, a lot of determination, a lot of perseverance. Now, it is something that is attainable through good old-fashioned hard work. So you've heard it said, nothing good comes easy. Well, this takes a lot of work, it takes a lot of studying, because ultimately you're gonna be taking care of patients and saving lives. Now, nursing is the most trusted profession, and there's a reason for that. It's the people that they choose to be nurses. Nurses usually have a big heart, they're very caring, they're very compassionate, and they also have a passion and a drive to take care of patients. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Remember, on this channel, we talk about nursing, health, education, and music. So, thank you for watching, and until the next video, bye-bye.